So in this organic chemistry, we discuss basic principle.
It produces sulfur dioxide.
Basic principles and techniques. So this is our first topic in organic chemistry for first year, basic principles and techniques. So now in that first introduction. So generally the carbon shows catenation property. Catenation property. Due to the catenation property, the carbon forms billions of compounds, a large number of compounds. And this catenation, generally the carbon shows a covalent bond. Due to the covalent bond, it is interact with nitrogen atom or hydrogen atom or oxygen atom. So different atoms are linking with carbon. And next, this under the separate branch, we discuss a carbon and their compounds. So such a branch is called as organic chemistry. So in organic chemistry, we discuss with carbon compounds and their properties. So this father of organic chemistry is Ohler. So the Ohler is the first scientist. He prepared a urea. Okay, he prepared the preparation of urea from inorganic compounds. Inorganic compounds. So the first organic compound is urea, that is prepared from an inorganic compound by a Ohler scientist. Ohler. So that's why he is the father of organic chemistry. So this urea is prepared from the inorganic compound, that is aminocyanato. This aminocyanato is heated. It produces urea. That urea formula is NH2C double bond O NH2. This is the formula of urea. Okay. And next, not only this one, the Kolbe, the acetic acid, the pioneer synthesis of acetic acid. Acetic acid. This acetic acid formula is CH3COOH. This acetic acid is prepared by Kolbe. Scientist. Or another one, the methane is prepared by Berthelot. So this is your introduction for carbon, for organic chemistry. Generally the carbon shows catenation property, means the linking of atoms and produce a large number of chain or more chain length. So the first prepared organic compound is urea from inorganic compound by a Ohler scientist. And the next one is the carbon. Generally the carbon forms, the carbon is a 4 valency. It containing its valency is 4. The carbon valency is 4. It ability to form only 4 bonds. And it exhibits a covalent bond nature. And next one is, generally the carbon structure, carbon is interactive with generally hydrogen atoms. It forms different types of compounds and involved in sp3 hybridization or sp2 hybridization or sp hybridization. Means in organic chemistry generally we are discuss only 3 types of hybridization. One is sp3, sp2 and sp hybridization. And generally the carbon compounds generally forms sigma bond and pi bond. So for example, in methane generally the hydrogen forms one sigma bond. Here 4 sigma bonds are present. Means all alkanes are formed sigma bonds. So these are methane, ane is the suffix. So this is alkane. Alkanes forms are sigma bonds. Whereas you are considered alkenes, CH2 double bond CH2, that is ethene. This ethene forms one pi bond. Okay, ethene containing, means alkenes are containing one pi bond. Next, ethyne, so alkyne. This alkyne containing two pi bonds, means generally the carbon compounds are containing sigma bond and as well as pi bond. So alkane, ane containing only sigma bonds alkene containing sigma bonds and one pi bond, alkyne containing sigma bonds and two pi bonds, and generally the pi bonds having less energy compared to sigma bonds. This is easily involving in reaction, especially for carbonyl compounds. So the pi bond is having less energy compared to sigma bond, and its valency is 4. Its ability to form only 4 sigma bond, only 4 bonds or 4 covalent bond character. And next one is, we discuss next topic, that is we discuss classification. So the classification of organic compounds.